Please welcome Mr. October, Reggie Jackson. What do you, we got a couple of minutes here, then we'll do a commercial and come back and talk a little bit later.
Can I give you a Christmas present a little early?
Well, sure. What do you got there?
Autographed baseball.
Well, thank you very much.
May not have very much value now because I'm now a has-been. But
No. Now, let's talk about that. That's what I was going to bring up. Thank you very much.
Has-been than it never was, right?
Yeah. What are you going to do now? Are you going to stay in baseball come spring training? You're not going to play another year, are you?
No, I don't think I'm going to play. I do have some discussions next week with the Oakland A's, with the Haas family who owns the team.
Mm-hmm. What will that be about?
Well, about what I would be probably about baseball.
Yeah.
although they own Levi Strauss, so maybe I'll be peddling jeans on the street.
Sure.
Either that or I was thinking of trying to still make $1 million a year and developing my own little three-card Molly stands around town.
Yeah.
But I'll be talking with them next week.
You wouldn't want to be a part-time player, though. I mean, you've never been happy when they used you as a designated hitter, really, have you?
Well, Dave, I was a part-time player the last couple of years, really.
Right.
And I think when a player gets a certain age in his career, and for me it happened when I was 38, 39. When I got to be 39, I had to realize and understand that there were other players coming along that even though they may not have been as good as me at the time, no matter what kind of year I had at the age of 39 or 40 or 41, the next year I wasn't going to exist.
No, you're expendable at that point.
And they had to bring someone else
along. It's inventory. So. We just keep turning over the inventory.
That's pretty much true.
So have we even answered this question or not?
Not really.
No, not really.
A bunch of rhetoric.
So you hope to stay in baseball another year, probably not as a player, maybe a coach. You wouldn't want to coach.
No,
bullpen catcher?
Well, it's... I want to try to...
Knocking fungos to the boys?
A couple of words here, but maybe I'll pull off Paul's act here and see if I can communicate a little better. A little Jim McMahon act here. What's this look like?
It looks great, Reggie. It just looks terrific.
No, I guess when I was coming along, Dave, people told me, said, you know, Reggie, when you get to be 30 years old, you're going to put weight on.
Yeah.
So when I got to 30, I watched myself, so to speak. Now, to bring the same philosophy along, people say, when you retire from baseball, you're going to want to stay in it. You're going to miss it.
Yeah.
I have a lot of things that I'm trying to do involved in the automobile industry. However, I'm meeting next week with the Oakland ownership and the general manager, Sandy Alderson, to try to do something to stay involved in the game of baseball. Be it a special assistant or a special assignment type person to
I could almost handle one of those gigs. I could be a special assistant.
You could be a special assistant.
Let you and I go to this meeting together. We'll both get jobs. We have to pause here for a little bit about you were destined to play in New York City, probably, and I'm guessing that of all the places you've played here, even though you had a lot of trouble, this will be what crystallizes and defines your career, probably, that experience, right?
You're correct. I've been asked that question quite a few times, and I guess if I'd have to say where was my career, where was my name really made, even though there were a lot of tough times here, I'd have to look back and say that the benefits, as you say, how my career did crystallize, it's been fabulous for me to have played here, and I've always considered it a privilege to wear the Yankee uniform.
Sure. Well, now, when you were a kid, heck, when I was a kid, baseball players more than likely would stay with one organization. There was not so much jumping from team to team to team. You were came up with Oakland?
Right.
Actually, Kansas City, right, in the beginning?
Kansas City. They moved to
Oakland. Then to Oakland, then to Baltimore.
Baltimore for one
New
year.
York.
New York for five.
California.
For five.
Back to Oakland.
Back to Oakland for one.
Now, when you were a kid dreaming about being a ball player, is that how you saw it, or did you want to be in
not
one
really,
team?
Not really, David. I think that everybody feels that they want to, you know, for your own security or ego or image or whatever it is, you want to say, I'm going to be with one team, I'm going to start my career and finish my career there, and they're going to love me, and it's going to be great and fabulous. But sometimes things don't work out that way. A ball club has certain needs. There have been players that hit 50 home runs, and the ball club finishes last, so you might as well trade that player. Yeah. I know for myself, I believe that part of the reason I move so much is because of my personality and openness, and I had problems with people that owned a ball club or had more authority than I did.
Let me interrupt you right there, and let's dwell on that for a second. We have a situation here where Billy Martin is back again. This is his 15th stint as manager of the Yankees. And George brings him back, and you know, I know, everybody watching, everybody sitting at Yankee Stadium knows that Billy probably won't make it through the 4th
of July.
Fatal
attraction.
Yeah. Well, what's your assessment now of Billy and also George?
Well, I guess as you get older, you look back on things a little bit differently. I know that Billy Martin knows the game of baseball and knows how to manage. I know that in playing for him, I always felt he managed. We had a 25-man roster at that time. He always managed with 21 or 22 guys because he disliked a few players, and consequently, they didn't wind up getting as much time.
So he just mentally took them off the roster.
He just didn't get along with them, and consequently, they didn't participate that
much.
You know, dealing with a George Steinbrenner is very, very difficult. The one thing I'll always remember him for is he made me wealthy and paid me and never missed a paycheck.
Yeah.
And in listening to my attorney and financial advisors and my father as well, they always said to me, Reggie, if you own the ball club, you got the right to do what you want to. So I could excuse a lot of the things that he did, although I may not have liked him or whatever.
He's still the guy signing the check,
and agree or not agree, he's got the right to pretty much do what he wants. You got to realize that this is the way it's going to be before you get here.
Yeah.
And many people fail to realize that. Everyone thinks they're different.
Right. Yeah. What about, is it Dave Righetti? They're talking about may go to Japan. I don't know if the deal has come and gone or what, but they're going to, some team in Japan is offering
$20 million.
$20 million. Now, is that going to happen?
I think that he should learn to eat rice and egg rolls.
Now,
learn a taste for sushi.
Could you have Bob Horner played over there this year? And everybody said he's going to hit 50 home runs easy.
Right,
what did he end up with?
I think 27 or 30, something like
that. He did not have the blockbuster year everybody was predicting.
It's not a bad year, though. 30 home runs isn't bad.
No. I mean, in American baseball, sure, but they thought he would just push them around.
I understand, Dave, that they won't let an American come over and set home run records.
Right.
Also, I understand they'll pitch around them.
Mr. O.
But for me, really, if a fella said they'd give me $3 or $4 million now to go to Japan, I'm going tomorrow.
No, you're not.
I buy a Christmas tree.
No, you're not.
I take a tree with me.
No.
I buy some snow in Colorado, and I roll over, you know?
But
I get over there. I'll pay you $20 grand a month to be my buddy over there if I get $20 million. Right?
But,
right? I moved my town over for $20 million. I mean, what the hell?
Hi, I'm Reggie's buddy. But seriously, your temperament, your personality, you wouldn't get off the bus at the airport.
Where?
In Japan.
I would now. I'm 41. My career's
over.
But
that's a whole different regimentation, isn't it? It's like being in the Marine Corps over
it
there.
It is, absolutely. But yeah. Dave, 20 mil. 20 mil.
All right. Now, do we need to mention this?
I would like to.
Is this wax or cocktail mix? I don't know. This is, you've developed your own kind of car wax.
Yes.
Being
a car nut, and I would call myself a car nut or car fool or car crazy.
Reggie's Liquid Wax, soon to be on the market.
Yes, right. I've got about 100 cars.
Listen, Reggie, we're out of time. I want to thank you for being here.
No,
we got to go.